Welcome to the Rock Church and World Outreach Center. We pray that this message will strengthen and encourage you. Now here's a message from one of our special guests.
If you've got your Bibles, why don't you turn with me? I want to talk to you about the ability to lift. Everybody say the ability to lift. It says in Psalm 121, verse 1. I love this little verse. It says, I lift up my eyes to the hills. Where does my help come from? Question mark. My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. I love this little passage because it's such a simple scripture, but it just kind of packs a little punch for me. I love the psalmist because he writes and he says, I lift up my eyes. You know, there has to be something in you. There has to be something in you that has the ability to lift. You know, when I discipline my children, I've got two beautiful children, and it's becoming less and less frequent that I have to discipline them, but I've got a 13-year-old, he's turning 13 next week, and my 10-year-old turned 10 a couple of weeks ago. But on occasion, when they're a little bit naughty, you know how it is, and you've caught them out, and they know that you know that they know that they've done something wrong, and you call them into the bedroom for a discussion, and you know, they kind of walk in with a little bit, with their head down, because they know that what they did was inappropriate. So whether they told a lie or did something bad, they knew. And isn't it true when we get a bad report or we've let God down perhaps, that it's hard for us to lift up our eyes per se because of the disappointment? That you've actually walked into the doctors, and haven't we all been like that? Where we've walked into the doctors and we're happy. And then, unfortunately, we get the bad report. And as soon as we walk out of the doctors, our countenance has changed. Isn't that true, somebody? Isn't our countenance changed? Hasn't our demeanor changed? We look down. People may come up to you and say, is there something wrong? Why? Because they can see that something's wrong in your eyes. But here the psalmist says, there's something inside of me that is determined that I will lift. What I'm trying to say is, if I could make you lift, I would. If I could get down there and, you know, just like, if I could do it to you, I would do it. Because the key to your miraculous, the key to your miracle is not to look to me, but to lift up your eyes. He says, I, me. Life is more about you than you realize. You choose to win. You choose to grow. You choose. It's you. Life is about you and your choices. The psalmist says, I lift me. This cannot be your forever. The way that you're living, the way that you're feeling, when I was praying early this morning, I was thinking, this cannot be your forever. Something has to shift for you. I'm praying for you. I'm believing for you. I'm hoping, trusting God that something's going to shift. But when it comes all down to it, I lift. The onus is actually on you. I can bring you to a place of faith, a place of belief. But there has to be something inside of you that says, you know what? He's right. This can't be my forever. I'm going to lift. He says to the mountains. He says, I lift my eyes to the mountains. God said to Abraham, Abraham, come out. Come out of that tent. Come on, you little tinker. Let's get out of here. Abraham's like, whoa, what's going on? It's the middle of the night. Look at the stars. Abraham looks up, he said, man, there's heaps of stars. He said, that's going to be like your descendants? That many. God wants us to look up where there is no roof, where there is no ceiling over what he can do. God can do far more than you think. My story, here I was, having had leukemia, the age of 13 to 18 years old. I mean, that's just a long time, 5 years in and out of hospital. When I was 15 years old, I gave my life to Christ. Dramatic moment. in a moment where I lifted up my eyes to the Lord. Yeah, go ahead if you want to clap, I don't mind. But here I am, 15, 16 years old, the leukemia came back. A lot more aggressive, a lot worse. When I was 18 years old, I was told I was terminal. And then there's like, the doctors come and, you know, kind of give you the bad news, because when you're 18, they tell you the truth. You know, we give up. There's nothing that could happen for you. I think, well, that's bad. My Catholic priest came and gave me my last rites, preparing me for burial, because my mum and dad were in Catholic Church. Who knows, that's a bad day. I mean, that's just a flat-out bad day. And then there's like these happy youth pastors. They've walked in. Well, it's kind of like a charismatic Presbyterian church. He said, we believe in a different report. We believe that God can heal you. I'm like, by the way, I like that you clap. I feel like we're friends if we're, you know, like, I'll never be upset if you clap or yell out, that's good preaching. Now, thank you. Now, but I could have said to them, why tease me now? I mean, I didn't really have faith. I mean, I believe the doctors, and don't we? I'm believing the doctors, I'm believing my Catholic priest. And then these guys come in saying, I could have said to them, why are you getting my hopes up? Why are you saying in this 11th hour, God would turn something around for me? And friend, you know what? Isn't it true that sometimes we're like that? We've believed the doctors, we've believed the bad report. So where was the miracle for me? Because I don't know if I had faith. The miracle for me was, even in my unbelief, allowing them to pray for me was enough faith. And the Bible says all you need is a seed. It was like enough faith, a sniff, a whiff. God says, I'll take that. I can use that. And look, here I am. God healed me. And that's why I don't think God's going to heal people. I know He's going to heal people, because God healed me. It's a different kind of faith. There's a knowing inside of me that one little lift, I decided, that little small bit, but just in my last moment go, you know what? I'll roll the dice one more time. I'll give God another shot. God says, I'll take it. He says, I lift up my eyes to the mountains, because this is where my help comes from. Huh. I love that. Where's your help coming from right now? Where is your help coming from? Now listen, I'm not saying that doctors are bad. They're not. They're great. I love them. They've helped me many, many, many times. But as a first response, where does your help come from? Would God be your first option? You know, what can happen is this, is you get a little bump, right? You go, I've got a bump. What do I need to do? I need to go to the doctor to get checked out, which is okay, legitimate. The doctor goes, ooh, I don't like the look of that. I go, oh, what do you mean? I thought it was just a bump. Ooh, yeah, that bump, yeah, gee, that is a bump. What do you mean? Do you think it's cancer? Ooh, I can't rule it out. We can't rule it out. Which is, you know, we have to do some more tests. So then, remember, your demeanor changes. It's hard to lift again. And now you're fighting something that's over your life. Wouldn't it be better, just an example, wouldn't it be better, oh, I've got a little bump. Bumps happen every now and then. I've got a little bump. Why don't you give God the first shot? Why don't you just give Him the first shot? Where's your help coming from? My son, he's 10 years old. Before I came on this trip, I'm driving him to school. He says, Dad, we've got to go to church on Sunday. I live in church. So like, I'm like, what are you talking about? He says, no, Dad, we've got to go to church. I want to go to big church. I said, Okay, cool. I said, why is that? He said, Dad, I went to school. When I was at school yesterday, I had a really bad headache. I said, did you? Why don't you tell me? He said, oh, Dad, I just did what you did. I just did what you would do. Well, I'm like frightened about that. Like that could be a thousand things. I'm like, what would that be? And he says, Dad, I just closed my eyes and I prayed. He said, Dad, it didn't work the first time. But he said, you know what? You told me never to give up. So he said, I did it a second time and then a third time. He said, by morning tea, it had gone. He said, Dad, yeah, he said, Dad, I want to go to church. The reason I want to go to church is I want to worship God and bring him an offering. I'm like, whoa, how cool is that? A 10-year-old. Well, let's be real. Who's bringing the offering? Like, it's coming down my room. I hope I get the credit for his offering. Amen. Lift up your eyes. Give God a first shot. Why wouldn't you give him a first crack? What would that mean? Come down to church. Get somebody to pray for you. You know, if I got sick in school, I would think it was the best thing. Because you would go to the nurses, the sick bay, and you'd lay on that bed. They'd bring you like chocolate, milk, cookies. They'd ring up your mum and say, pick up your son. That would have been my dream to get out of school. My son is praying in his school. Where is your help coming from? You know, I need to go quick because I really do want to pray for so many people, and I know there are many miracles here today. He says, I lift up my eyes to the mountains. Where does my help come from? It comes from the maker of heaven and earth. He's just underscoring again. Just reminding, putting another layer on that little verse that really God is big. Friends, this is not a game or a dress rehearsal. This is it. And God is amazing. He's not angry or upset. He wants you to win. You know, my brother was diagnosed with terminal cancer recently, just a few months ago, actually. And it was a nerve-wracking moment. And my mum, I'm the youngest of eight in my family, very cold in New Zealand. She said, you got to go down and pray for your brother. He's not in church. In fact, he was a little bit anti-church. But I love my brother, and of course I would go. And so I was really prayed up. You know, it's easy to witness to other people, but family, who knows, it's a little bit quirky. And so it's my brother, my oldest brother. It's like, oh, you know. So I'm going in. Don't really like hospitals anyway because of the smell, you know, because I've been there for so long and just, you know, associations with that. And I walk into this room, and I've got to tell you, I felt bad already. I felt like a spirit of death was already in the room, a feeling. You know, have you ever said, I've walked across somebody's grave, and you get the heebie-jeebies, you know, it's kind of, that's what we say in New Zealand, it's like, ooh, you yuck. I walked in that room, I felt, ooh, this is not a good start. We began talking with my brother, I was playing cards with him, trying to fill in time, you know what I mean, and there was another person in the room, And so anyway, we're talking away, and I finally got up enough courage to say to him, can I pray for you? His friend begins to manifest, yell at me, swear at me, say, what are you doing here? Who do you think you are? I find out later that she's a witch. Yeah, like a real witch, which is kind of interesting. And I said to her, I said, well, who are you? And she said, I'm your brother's friend. We're teachers together. And I said, well, I'm the brother, so I win. Amen. I think that's a good thing. So, like, and then I said, and greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. I didn't know what I was speaking to. And I said to my brother, how about it then? He said, do it. So I'm thinking, he's probably thinking that I'm going to go home and pray for him. that is not what's going to happen right now. I pull the curtain because, you know, there's other people in the room for privacy. And then I went for it. Started praying for him. 30 seconds into the prayer, he interrupts me. And he says, Andrew, he said, something's happening to me. The curtain, there's no air conditioning on, no windows open. The curtain begins to move as the spirit of death leaves and a spirit of faith comes into that room. He's got a name. His name is the Holy Spirit. He comes into that room and it's just amazing. My brother says out loud, Andrew, everything's going to be okay. I said, man, I said, whatever you do, keep on saying that. Because my Bible says that words have power. And friend, what you think about and what you talk about locates you. That's exactly where you're heading. But if you can change that around, say, you know what, everything's going to be okay. I said to my brother, for the next 48 hours, please, please say that. Then I'm standing there in this room. I can hear the Holy Spirit talking to me. He says, son, prophesy over him. Tell him that everything's going to be okay. Tell him that the cancer is now gone. That his bladder, which was filled with cancer and he had to use a special bag to go to the bathroom, is now fully formed. Tell him that the doctors are going to say in 2 days' time that they are embarrassed that they've misdiagnosed him. I'm going, God, if I get it wrong, he won't believe. I'm not saying I'm a prophet. I'm not saying I always get it wrong, but right then I needed to get it right. And I was just worried that if I was to say it and then it didn't happen, he wouldn't find God. And as I was bowing my heads, this is not a 2-hour conversation, these are flashes, moments. He said to me, Andrew, the same voice you heard when you were baptized in the Holy Spirit is the same voice you're hearing now. It's me. And I said, Lord, that's it then. And I said to my brother, can I pray for you one more time? He says, go ahead. So, church, I went for it. I said, today, this is the day the Lord has made. I said, the cancer is now gone. I said, your bladder is fully formed, fully functioning. All those tumors in your body are shifting off your life. A spirit of pain's leaving. Healing's coming into your world. In 2 days' time, the doctors are going to say they've misdiagnosed you and you'll be out of hospital within the week. He's weeping. I've got good news, friends. He is now cancer-free. 2 days' time, the doctor said we've misdiagnosed him. Bladder is fully formed. Come on, you can clap a bit better than that. Oh, he's good. Isn't he kind? Isn't God good? I said to my brother, well, you better come to church then. He goes, all right. He's sitting in the front row. I'm preaching. I think if I've got one shot, I'm going to give it to him. I think, what would Pastor Jim talk about? I did a message called Who and How Knows Jesus. Talks about four people who have a knowledge of God but no relationship with God and end up in hell. I preached my best message. And I said, is there anybody who wants to give their life to Christ? This is my good altar call. Lift your hand now. And my brother lifted his hand. Other people lifted as well, but I could care less. Amen. That's not true. But I was excited that my brother lifted his hand. He was crying, weeping, very emotional. He said to me on the altar call, he says, Andrew, what am I feeling? Why am I feeling like this? I said, it's your spirit coming home. This is what home feels like. We spend the whole day together talking and laughing and just enjoying, you know, just great fellowship. We're driving home late at night and he says to me, Andrew, would you stay with me? I said, what do you mean? He said, I want you to stay in my house. I said, I'm not staying at your house. Are you crazy? I'm going to go home. I said, why do you want me to stay with you? He says, I'm scared. But when I sleep, I won't wake up feeling like I'm feeling. He said, I never want this feeling to ever leave me. That's what home feels like. When you're connected to God, it just feels awesome. God loves us. He's on our side. The psalmist says, I lift up my eyes to the Lord. Because this is where my help comes from. You know, it's kind of hard to ask God for help when he's not real in your life. Do you know what I mean? It's a little bit kind of crazy. God, help me, but I'm not following you. It's kind of good if you're on his side. You know, God heals unchurched people. He did for my brother. But somehow God oversaw that big plan, you know what I mean? I just thought, you know what, today, before we pray for miracles, let's just ask that question to our soul. Am I in relationship with God? And I reckon that's a good prayer. That's an honest prayer. That's not manipulative. That's not confusing. That's just you and God talking. And I want to explain to you what's going to happen so you don't feel tricked. But in a moment, I'm going to ask you to close your eyes, because when you close your eyes, everything disappears, but your soul and your thoughts are illuminated. And I want you to ask this question to your soul. Am I in relationship with God? And I think that is an honest prayer. And what I know is God will talk to you. There may not be an audible voice shouting from you, but certainly there will be a stirring and knowing inside your heart. And I want you to respond to that voice. You know, what I've known is because I've been around this atmosphere for such a long time, this thing, there's a fight for your miracle. As soon as God talks to you, there'll be another voice, another prompting, 100%. Because the devil will say, don't you do it. Don't listen to the devil. John 10:10 says the devil comes to kill, steal, and destroy. But God would come that you'd have life and life in all of its fullness. Let me just tell you from the get-go, the devil does not want you to become a Christian. He does not want you to be healed. He wants your marriage to fail. He wants you to be lonely, depressed, beaten up. That's his whole agenda, is to keep you away from the miraculous. And if the devil prompts you today, if that little voice comes, you just stamp your foot and go, devil, no. Today it's about me, my life, my miracle. Something is going to shift for me. And give God this window. Give him an opportunity so that this is not your forever. The devil may have had up till now, but now, come into blessing. Come into that relationship with God. As you're pondering that thought, I'm going to pray for you. At the end of the prayer, I'm going to ask you to lift up your hand if you want to invite Christ to come into your life or rededicate your life to the Lord. I'll see your hand. I ask you to put it down. All together, we're going to pray that prayer out loud so you don't feel alone or embarrassed. And I'm believing for something amazing to happen. God sees everything. What does a miracle look like? What does a lift look like? It can just look like that. And that prayer is a gateway to a brand new relationship with God. Come on, friends. Can we just start the night off by doing that? I think just somebody needs to get honest with God today. Something's going to turn around. Why don't you just close your eyes? Just look inside your soul right now and just say, God, today, am I in relationship with God? I think it's an honest prayer. God will talk to you. Let me pray for you, God. I thank you for those people who are here for the first time, second time, maybe visiting from another church and saying, Andrew, it's true. I know about God, but if I'm honest, I'm not really in relationship with him. But something has to shift for me. Something has to turn for me. This cannot be my forever. I felt like I was, as I said before, there are numerous people here saying, I cannot have another year like last year. From this moment and beyond, something has to turn. Or maybe you're here, you're saying, Andrew, you know what? It's sin that's separating me from God. Perhaps a wrong relationship. Or maybe a secret sin that nobody else would know about, but God sees everything. And I'm separated from Him, but I need to come back into that place where I'm close to Him. Or maybe you're saying, Andrew, if I was to face death like you had to as a teenager, if I was to walk out of this room, get hit by a car, stand before God, I don't know if I'd be in heaven or hell. There'd be a fear and uncertainty around that moment. But would you pray with me so I can have a relationship with God, walk in that relationship, have that assurance of my salvation? Come on, friend. If that's you, just slip up your hand right now and say, Andrew, pray with me. You can be honest today. What does a lift look like? Lifting your hands. Just, this is the moment. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. I see them. Thank you, thank you. The very back, thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. At the very back, sir, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Who else on this side? Thank you. Lift it up high. Thank you, thank you, thank you. All these hands, thank you, thank you, thank you. Who else? Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Who else? Thank you, thank you. Who else? You're saying, Andrew, that's me. You're saying, Andrew, I'm not sure. Friend, how do you think the devil would come and bring uncertainty around your life? Do you think he's going to turn up in a red suit and a pitchfork? No, he's going to whisper to you. It'll be subtle, but it'll have a point to it. Don't let the devil win. Not tonight. Give God this window and let a miracle come into your life. Be honest. Lift up your eyes to the Lord. You've tried everything else. Give God this window. Is there somebody else saying, Andrew, that's me? Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Who else? Come on, please. I'm fighting for your miracle. Thank you. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Who else? Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. See these hands. Who else? You're saying, Andrew, that's me. I'm not talking about you missed your quiet time last night. I'm talking about when you look inside your soul, you're lost. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Every person that lifted your hand, maybe you didn't, or maybe you did, but now's the time. I want you to do it one more time for me. I don't want to miss anybody. Could you lift it high enough so I can see? High enough so I can see. Could I even take a moment just to count? Why count? Because I believe God counts every single person coming to Christ. Let me count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50, 51, 52, 53, 54, 55, 56, 56, 57, I've lost count. 57, 58, 59, 60, 61, 62, 63, 64, 65, 66, 67, 68, 69, 70, 71, 72, 73, 74, 75, 76, 77, 78, 79, 80, 81, 82, 83, 84, 85, 85, 86, 87, 88, 89, 90, 91, 92, 93, 94, 95. Thank you, sir. 95. 96, 97, 98, 99, 100, 101, 102, 103, 104, 105. God bless you, sir. Come on, let's give the Lord a big clap and give it just a good one. Isn't he kind? Isn't he good? I love our God. God is beautiful. Jesus is beautiful. He's the one who died on the cross, taking away our sin. Friend, just where you are, would you just put your hand on your heart as we pray this prayer together? Because that's what we're kind of opening up to God today. Pray it with passion with me. Pray it out loud. Follow me in this prayer. Come on, church, help me out. Dear Lord Jesus, tonight I'm asking you into my life as my Lord and Savior. I give you my life. I give you total control. Help me live for you every day in your presence. Forgive me for any wrong. for any sin. Because I know you died on a cross to take away the sin of the world. Take away my sin. Today I am a new creation, a child of God. Now let me pray for you, God. I thank you for every person that lifted their hand. God, I pray that you would make a way for them. Thank you that we are in the family of God, that your promise is that you remember as sin no more. It's like from the east to the west. God, there is no condemnation in you. And God, I pray that the miraculous would fall over families and lives, and healing would take place. We would go out tonight knowing that we've come home. God, we thank you for this house, for this church. In Jesus' name, amen. Come on, give God a clap and thank him. You know, I always say to people who make decisions for Christ, decision is not just a decision, it's a lifestyle. What I mean by that is, make sure that you come back to church. Surround yourself with the miraculous. Salvation is not just a one-time prayer. It's a relationship with God. And God really does want you to win. You're going to find, because I know the pastor's here, you're going to find this just a beautiful place to learn, to grow, and to be blessed. Hey, you know what? I would like to pray for some miracles. Would that be okay? We believe God for some of that. I always just ask the Holy Spirit, you know, just for just a couple of words, just to you know, to demonstrate. And I really felt like God told me that there were some people who have just been in a car accident, some ladies, and maybe your back was really damaged or your hip, and you're in a lot of pain. Who would those people be? I don't need a word of knowledge. It's going to be like 10 or so people. Who are those people? Could you just come forward just straight away? Could you just come? You can just hop out and just come and stand here. I promise I won't bite. I can't promise anything else, but I promise that. Hi, how you doing? Good. Were you in a car accident?
No.
No, but you got a pain in your body?
Yeah.
Okay, well, that's cool. I'm going to pray for you in a minute. Don't worry. We'll just wait a little bit. Let's give these guys a hand as they come up. Come on, are you coming? Don't be shy. I'm friendly, I promise. Hi, how you doing? What's wrong with you?
I've been on dialysis for the past 2 years.
Oh, okay. All right. Hey, just remember when I call something out, just listen to what I'm saying. Because, you know, I said car accident and you've been in pain, or it doesn't have to be a car accident actually, but what's happening with you? Oh, darling.
I'm a cancer patient.
And a cancer? Oh, darling. That's no good. What about yourself, love? Oh, darling. What about yourself?
I have problems.
Problems? Yeah, me too. We all got problems. Amen. Were you in an accident? No? Were you in an accident?
No.
No? Oh, are you like friends?
Yes.
Is your daughter?
No.
No? You can be. We can make this. Who was in the car accident? Anybody like in the car accident? You were in a car accident? Darling. Why are you crying? Don't cry.
I
don't know what to do when girls cry. Honestly, I don't. When Janine cries, I say, stop it. I don't know what to do now. Then this is going to be a happy day. Okay? Why are you sad?
I'm happy.
You're happy?
I believed you.
Well, cry happy, okay? It's like it's too emotional. It'll be all right, I promise it'll be okay. I promise it'll be okay. Listen, God can work with your eyes open and smiling. You don't have to be strange to be powerful. God wants to use you, just your normal you, okay? So if you're wondering what's going to happen, that's what's going to happen, okay? Nothing too crazy. But let me just say this before we pray for people. This is not the Andrew Kabbalah show. We're all going to pray. Please. Like, I really mean it. So you thought you're just going to sit back and just, you know, watch the show and have some popcorn. That's not going to happen. This is work time, okay? Oh, please, don't go quiet on me now. Is it work time? Bless you, church. When I pray for a friend, I'm always thinking, this could be my mum, or it could be my dad. And that changes the way I pray. And you should think the same. So why don't you stretch out your hands just right now, and let's pray with passion. So normally you'd open your mouth and say things like, God, thank you for healing me. We're going to be here a long time. So, God, thank you for healing her. So just say that. Keep on saying it. Whew. Now, sweetheart, I'm going to pray for you. Where's the sorest part in your body? Down here? Down the back? All the way down? Yeah. Are you going to feel warmth come through my hands in about 10 seconds? Just we'll trust him with this, okay? He won't drop it. You're going to feel warmth come through my hand in about 10 seconds. The power of God's going to touch your life. Father, in the name of Jesus. Here comes, Father, infirmity and sickness. Come on, church, pray like you mean it. Shift over this life right now. Infirmity and sickness, I command you to go and to leave right now in the Jesus' name. All this pain is going to shift over this body. Miracles are going to fall. Everything's going to turn around in Jesus' name. Let it fall, let it fall, let it fall. Don't leave me up here, bro. Father, in the name of Jesus, let it fall, let it fall, let it fall, let it fall, let it fall. Let it fall, let it fall, let it fall, let it fall. In Jesus' name. Here comes. Pain leaving your body. Everything turning around. Everything's going to change. This is the day the Lord has made. And just as you said, I knew, I knew, I knew. So did God. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. What's your name, love?
Julie.
Julie?
Yes.
Come up here, Julie. It's going to be a brand new day for you. Let this man help you up. Is it Julie? It is Julie.
I need for 8 more people.
8 more people?
Yeah.
Well, we've got faith for that. But Julie, lift your hand up. How's your neck going? Pardon? No more pain? No. Julie, that's better than me. How you feeling?
Feeling good.
You feeling good? Look at you. You're so nice. We should be friends on Facebook or something. What are we doing? You're so nice, Julie. Now, Julie, listen to me. Can I do you the biggest favor? For the next 48 hours, will you do something for me? Every time you think about your situation, just say, God, thank you for healing me. No, listen, because it's important. Sometimes you have to fight for your miracle. The devil's only got one trick. He'll meet you in the car park, right? And he'll say, hey, that's not going to last. That's not going to happen. And so you've got to fight for your healing. Just say no. If he comes to kill, rob what? Rob your miracle. He's trying to rob your salvation. That's what he's trying to do. And he's only got one trick to bring in accusation. This isn't going to happen. This isn't going to work. But Julie, that one day that you're pain-free is going to turn into a week. That week's going to turn into a year. That year's going to turn into a lifetime. God, I pray right now for all those other people that are going to be healed in Jesus' name. Those 8 other miracles are going to happen in this life in Jesus' name. Now, in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you, Julie. Amen. This guy's going to help you. Do you want to? Oh, give me some sugar. I love hugs. Good. I'm a big hugger from way back. Now, who else was in that car accident? All my car accident people, just come up here. All my little car accident people. You're not very good drivers around here, eh? I'm just saying, something going to help you out. It's all right to laugh in church, isn't it? Do you think God's disappeared? I don't think he has. Who can feel an atmosphere beginning to shift over this place? I can feel healing coming off this stage right now. The power of God falling on people's lives in Jesus' name. I'll come. Now, where's the sorest part of your back? How long have you been sore for?
Since 07.
07?
Yeah.
Pastor Jim should have asked me earlier.
Two car accidents.
That was a little joke. That's a little evangelist joke. Sorry.
Two car accidents.
Was any of them your fault?
Not my fault. No,
exactly. No. That's what my wife tries to tell me as well. Is it right here? Is it okay if I put my hand there?
Yes.
Now, I want you just to close your eyes. Now, you don't need to fall over to be healed. So just relax, and my friend's just got his hand on, he's just steadying yourself. I mean, if you want to fall over, you can fall over. If you don't want to fall over, you don't have to fall over. Do you know what I mean? Yeah. Here comes the power of God. Now, the whole church is praying for you. You might never be able to tell yet. Help me out, church. Come on. God's so good. All these years of pain is going to fall off your life right now. I command that vertebrae to strengthen and straighten in Jesus' name. Just with your eyes closed, not out loud, just say, God, thank you for healing me. No, not out loud, just in your head. Because I want you not to look to me, I want you to look to God. Lift up your eyes to the Lord. This is where your help's going to come from. Here comes warmth coming into your back right now. Father, in the name of Jesus, infirmity and sickness, I command you to shift off this life. Healing's going to come. Infirmity's going to shift off her. I command that vertebrae to strengthen and straighten. Everything's going to turn around. Everything's going to change. There are other miracles that are going to happen in your life as well. Other miracles that are going to fall around your life in Jesus' name. In fact, there's other parts of your body, other ailments that you didn't say, but yet God sees everything. Everything's going to turn around. Can you feel that warmth coming into your back? Sweetheart, that's what healing feels like. That's the power of God coming into your life. Everything's turning around. Everything's going to change. This is the day the Lord has made. And you're going to rejoice and be glad in it. And somehow, I feel like God's saying that there was an instance. Maybe, perhaps you weren't going to come tonight. But because you came, it was like a miracle in that stretch. The power of God falling through your life. Can you feel my hand just got hotter then? He's taking away pain. Pain's a spirit. I firmly believe that. And it's shifting off you right now in Jesus' name. God, let it fall, let it fall, let it fall, let it fall. Let it fall, let it fall, let it fall. Can you feel that warmth? You can? That's God. I like you as well. You're so nice. Just bend down. You'll find yourself on a brand new day. Just bend down a little bit. Whew. How's that feeling, sweetheart? Good?
Great.
Where's that microphone, bro? Come here. What do you mean it's good?
It's great.
Where's that microphone? Have I got a microphone somewhere? Oh, thanks, Dan. You're a good-looking man, Dan. So when I was praying, because these guys don't know, I just thought, when I was praying for you, what were you feeling?
A warm sensation in my back.
Was it just right. Is it because I've got a hot hand, or is it deeper than that?
No, it was deeper and deeper and deeper. It went stronger and stronger each time.
Wow.
You had your hand on my back.
And now how are you feeling?
I feel good.
You feel good?
I feel real good.
Yeah, and were you in pain before at service?
Yes.
And now it's gone?
Yes. I feel good.
Sweetheart, that's what healing is. You know, like some people wonder what healing is. Let me just tell you. When the pain's gone, that's healing. All right? So like I'm just telling you, like when the pain leaves, that means you've been healed. So that's a pretty good day. Now listen, what's your homework? What, you remember what your homework was?
I want to thank God for my healing. Thank God for my healing.
Promise? Give me a high five.
High five.
You promise?
Yes, I promise.
Now listen. Because it's a bigger fight than you think. Because you can forget. Don't forget. Wake up. Say, God, thank you for my healing. You know, there are 10 lepers. Kind of like 9 got a bad rap. Why? Because they didn't go back. Say, hey, big gun.
Okay.
Hey, oh, more hugs. This is a hugging church, Pastor Jim. I like it. Who else are we praying for? You don't speak English?
No.
Why matter? I'll pray for you anyway.
Okay.
Have you got pain in your body?
Yeah, my back.
Your back?
And
where's the sorest part of your back? Where's sorest?
Okay.
here? Good girl. Just close your eyes. The whole church is praying. Oh, you're getting good now. You're showing off now, aren't you? Love you guys. God, we thank you for healing. We thank you for the power of God falling on this life. Infirmity and sickness, I bind and break its power. A lifetime of pain. Going to shift off this life right now. Everything's going to turn around. Everything's going to change. Right here, right now, the power of God, let it fall, let it fall, let it fall, let it fall. Here comes that warmth coming into your back, into your shoulders. The miracle power of God. Fall, let it fall, let it fall, let it fall, let it fall. Can you feel that? Amen. If you've got cancer in your body, why don't you slip out of your seat? Come and just stand here. I want to pray for you, if you can. If you've got problems with cancer or things like that, just come. Just come and stand down here. If you've got a terminal disease, I want you to come. If you've got something wrong with your body, they said, this is it, you're gonna die or whatever. Let's believe God. My brother had that spoken over him. I had that spoken over me. Things turned around. And we believe it can turn around for you as well. Amen? Amen. No, just stay down there. It's fine. I'll come down to you. It's good. Amen. Just come over here. Let's come over here. Maybe just some other people coming to stand behind these people. Just lift your hands out like you're about to receive. Yeah. Just lift your hands like you're about to receive a miracle. Just lift your hands. Just lift your hands. Here comes the power of God. Let it fall, let it fall, let it fall, let it fall. Let it fall, 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 let it fall. Let it fall, let it fall, let it fall, let it fall, let it fall. Let it fall, let it fall, let it fall. Here comes the power of God. Touch this life, God. Healing's going to come. Everything's going to turn around. Everything's going to change. Here comes the power of God. Let it fall, let it fall, let it fall. Fall, let it fall. I'm telling you right now, there's a miracle inside you. The power of God is going to fall. Let it fall, let it fall, let it fall, let it fall, let it fall. He's got you. Don't worry. In Jesus' name, let it fall, let it fall. There's other people with cancer, other people with terminal disease. Maybe it's your very first time in church. Why don't you just slip out of your seat? Just give God this little window. You can do it. Don't be shy. When I saw this altar call, when I saw this, when I was praying, I see things. There are a lot more people. I remember this altar call being filled with people. You know, there are more people. So I'm wondering, are you just hesitating for a little bit? But if you've got a thing that the doctor said, that is it. That's no longer, that you're going to have that. I want you to come. Can I, you know, just slip out of your seat and come. If you're thinking, should I, shouldn't I? Well, you might as well. You've got nothing to lose. I'm not going to be upset with you. Just slip out of your seat and just come and stand and let's just believe God for this moment. Amen? Amen. Here comes the power of God. Let it fall, let it fall, let it fall, let it fall. I pray for her, Father, in Jesus' name. Here comes the power of God. Let it fall, let it fall, let it fall, let it fall. I can feel the power of God just falling right now. Pain's leaving your body. Infirmity and sickness is going. Let it fall, let it fall, let it fall, let it fall. Let it fall, let it fall, let it fall, let it fall, let it fall. Let it fall, let it fall, let it fall, let it fall. Come on, cancer, shift off this life. Everything's going to turn around. Everything's going to change. Here comes the power of God. Let it fall, let it fall, let it fall. Let it fall. Why don't we all just stand just for a minute? Everybody else, if you need healing in your body, I just need you to lift one hand just nice and high. Wow, there's a lot. If you're standing with a Christian, beside a Christian, they can put their hand on your shoulder. That'd be appropriate. And let's just all pray this prayer together. You know, I was in an event. There were probably over 10,000 people in this one event. And as we just prayed corporately, and the power of God just fell in this place. There would have been maybe over 5,000 people who said instantly they were healed. That same presence, I can feel it right here, right now. And we're going to pray a prayer, a confession, breaking sickness over our life. And the power of God's going to fall, and miracles are going to come into your world. As we're praying, let's pray with passion. Tell the devil, who's the boss? Pray with me. Dear Lord Jesus, tonight, I submit myself to God and I resist the devil. I command a spirit of infirmity and sickness, death and destruction to shift off my life. I come against a spirit of pain to come off my life. Let's say it again. I command a spirit of death and destruction, infirmity and sickness, and pain to come off my life. Your word says, by my stripes, I am healed. I'm telling the devil and all his works that I am healed in the name of Jesus. Come off me in Jesus' name. Never come back. This is the day that the Lord has made. And I will rejoice and be glad in it. Jesus, thank you for healing me. Thank you that pain is gone. Tumors have left. Ears are opened. In Jesus' name. Lift your hands to the Lord. God, I thank you, Lord, right now. The power of God's going to fall in this meeting like a mighty rushing wind. Release your Holy Spirit. Like I can feel the power of God, like the wind of God coming off this stage and healing, touching people's lives. I'm telling you, people with arthritis are going to be healed. People with degenerative diseases are going to be healed. Everything's going to turn around. Everything's going to change. This is the day that the Lord has made. We're going to rejoice and be glad in it. I'm telling you, there's people with joint pains. It's going to shift off your life. Cancer will bow its knee to the Lord of Lords and the King of Kings. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Lift your hands towards these people right now. I'm telling you, I've got faith in this place. God, I pray for this little one. The miraculous is going to fall. Stretch out your hands. Come on. Worship team, join us. God, I pray right now. Let it fall, let it fall, let it fall, let it fall. Everything's going to turn around. Everything's going to change. God, I thank you, Lord, right now, the power of God. Touch this life. Right now, touch this life in Jesus' name. Touch this life. You've got catchers standing behind you. It's fine. Father, in the name of Jesus, shift over this life. Shift over this life in Jesus' name. Everything's going to turn around. Everything's going to change. Here comes the power of God. Let it fall, let it fall, let it fall, let it fall. Let it fall, let it fall, let it fall, let it fall. Let it fall, let it fall, let it fall, let it fall. Here comes the power of God. Let it fall, let it fall, let it fall. Healing's coming into this body in Jesus' name. The power of God. Let it fall, let it fall, let it fall, let it fall. Here comes the power of God. Sweetheart, I'm going to pray for you. Here comes the power of God. Let it fall, let it fall, let it fall, let it fall. Let it fall, let it fall, let it fall, let it fall. Let it fall, let it fall, let it fall, let it fall. Let it fall, let it fall, let it fall, let it fall. Let it fall, let it fall, let it fall, let it fall. Here comes the power of God.
Amen.
Amen. God, touch this life. God, we pray for Mom. Here comes the power of God. Let it fall, let it fall, let it fall, let it fall. Everything's going to turn around. Everything's going to change. This is the day. Telling you, Pastor Jim, there's going to be testimony after testimony after testimony of miracles on this very platform. People saying, you know, I had cancer, but now it's gone. I had this condition, now it's gone. This condition, now it's gone. This condition, he's got you. He's got you. He's got you. It's fine. Father, in the name of Jesus. Come on, catch us. You're going to have to be a bit faster. Father, in the name of Jesus. Let the power of God touch this life. Here comes the power of God. Let it fall. Let it. Power of God falling, let it fall, let it fall. Everything's going to turn around. Everything's going to change. Here comes the power of God. Let it fall, let it fall, let it fall, let it fall. Let it fall, let it fall, let it fall, let it fall. Here comes the power of God. Let it fall, let it fall. He's got you. He's got you, darling. He's got you. He's got you. Jesus' name. Jesus' name. Let it fall, let it fall, let it fall, let it fall. Everything's going to turn around. Everything's going to change. Stretch out your hands, church. Don't give up. Pray with me. Let it fall, let it fall, let it fall, let it fall. Let it fall, let it fall, let it fall, let it fall. Here comes the power of God. Touch this life again. Touch this life again. Let it fall. Healing coming in right now. Strong. Power of God falling. Let it fall, let it fall. Let it fall, let it fall, let it fall. Let it fall, let it fall. Does he need a miracle? You do? I'm going to pray for you, my friend. God, let power of God touch his life. Let the power of God fall, let it fall, let it fall. Let a miracle come into his bones, into his life in Jesus' name. This is the day that the Lord has made. God, I would pray that the doctors would say, we've never had such a quick recovery. Everything's going to turn around. Everything's going to change. in Jesus' name. Bless his life. Healing in Jesus' name. Healing over these lives. Touch his life in Jesus' name. Here comes the power of God. Falling, let it fall, let it fall, let it fall. Let it fall, let it fall, let it fall, let it fall. Let it fall, let it fall. Let a miracle come into this life today. In Jesus' name. Let a miracle come into this life. That's what you need, my friend. You need a miracle. It comes from God. And I believe as you came to church tonight, you lifted your hands. God saw everything. God, I pray right now in Jesus' name, there's a new relationship. There's a new connection. I'm believing. I'm standing with this church saying when you go back to the doctors, they would say something's turned around. Something's shifting. Something's turning. And you will laugh again at the goodness of God. God, I thank you for the miraculous falling on this life in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord, right now. Let the power of God, let it fall, let it fall, let it fall, let it fall. Let it fall, let it fall. I can feel the power of God coming. God, touch this life in Jesus' name. God, I pray right now the power of God falling, let it fall, let it fall. All around this neck, this back. Father God, in Jesus' name, her stomach as well. Father God, I pray right now the power of God falling, let it fall, let it fall. Pain is going to shift off your body in Jesus' name. Lift your hands, church. Come on, stretch out the hands. Father, in the name of Jesus, God, touch these lives. I can feel healing coming through my body right now. It's all right, just put it down. Father, in the name of Jesus, God, I thank you, Lord, right now. The power of God falling, let it fall, let it fall. Isn't God good? Isn't he kind to us? Isn't he kind in Jesus' name? God, I thank you for this beautiful life. God, I pray for healing. Arthritis is going to go. Sickness is leaving. Everything's turning around. God, we come against that spirit of cancer. It's going to fall, let it fall, let it fall. Let it fall, let it fall, let it fall, let it fall. I'm telling you, there's more than one miracle that God's going to do in your life. Can you feel that warmth coming into your back through my hand? That's healing. Touch this life. Touch this life in Jesus' name. Touch this life in Jesus. Stretch out your hands, church. You know, church, I just got to say, God is not ageist. God wants to heal the young and the older people. God doesn't want us to die with pain or with cancer. He wants you to die healthy. I believe that with all my heart. And I've seen hundreds of people healed. And I'm believing right now. When you go back to the doctors, I'd say, you know what? We've never seen such a quick recovery. We're confused now. We thought it was this, but maybe it's not. And I think that's what's going to happen. As I'm standing here, they're going to say, we're changing our mind. God's so good to us.
Amen.
What a beautiful life. You're so nice.
Thank you.
What's your name, dear?
Lou.
Lou. And how do you know this gentleman? Do you know him? No? Is he your catcher?
I came with my neighbor.
You came with your neighbor? Where's your neighbor? Neighbor, come here. Did you bring your friend?
She has cancer and I wanted her to come.
Did you lift you up your hand and pray that
I
prayer?
Did.
Shush. You did? I'm so proud of you. I know. I know. It is between God and us. But now you're a part of the family. So that's good. That's going to be nice. We can be Facebook friends now. I'm joking. That's joking. That's a bad joke. Now listen, whatever that lady tells you to do, you just do that. She's helped you this far.
She's my neighbor.
Yeah, it's good to have neighbors. You're a good neighbor.
You're awesome. Thank you.
No, you're beautiful. Come on, let's pray, guys. Is this okay, church? We're nearly done. Give me one more minute. Father, in the name of Jesus, healing. Healing, healing, healing. Touch this little man. Let a miracle happen for him. Everything's going to turn around. The doctors don't always get it right. Father God, I pray in Jesus' name, a miracle's going to fall. God, we love you. We honor you. We give you all the praise. Healing's going to come into this life. Bless this family in Jesus' name. Dear darling, Father, in the name of Jesus, touch this life. Touch this life. God, we thank you, Lord. Touch this life in Jesus' name. He didn't forget you. It's funny. Sometimes I can feel what people were thinking. He loves you so much. He loves you so much. You haven't disappointed him. Miracles are going to fall around your life. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Here comes the power of God. Let it fall, let it fall, let it fall. Let it fall, let it fall, let it fall. Isn't God good? Isn't He kind? Let the power of God just come and touch these lives. Let the power of God fall, let it fall, let it fall. Church, lift your hands just one more time. Would you lift it just one more time for me? Just lift it. Give all God, all the praise to God. It's His name. God's good. Just thank Him just 10 more times out loud. Just say, God, thank you for healing me. Just say it out loud. God, thank you for healing me. Come on, church. Give Him some praise. God, thank you for healing me. Thank you for healing me. Thank you for healing me. Amen. Everybody, just look this way. I want you to do something for me. Right where you are, I want you to test out. Maybe you had a pain in your body or your knee or your back or your hearing was blocked or you had migraines, but now you haven't. I want you to test out. Give yourself a good wiggle. That's what I'm talking about. Give yourself a good wiggle. Now listen to me. I know that God's healed people. Give me a wave if you know that God's done something in your life. Now give me a decent wave if you know that God's healed you. You could be my favorite church ever. Come on, give God praise. Thank Him.
Hey, you just heard that altar call. You just wanted to give God all of your heart and all of your life. Now let me lead you simply in a prayer of inviting Jesus Christ into your heart as your Lord and Savior. In fact, why don't you just go ahead and listen to me and go ahead and close your eyes and just repeat these words after me. I'll go slow. You repeat them. Say these words. Say, Father God, I come to you in the name of Jesus. I believe that Jesus Christ is your only begotten Son and that you sent Him for me and that He died for me on that cross at Calvary. I believe that His blood washes away my sins, that I am now a new creature in Christ Jesus. And I thank you, Lord. I receive you now and forever as my Lord and as my Savior. I'm going to turn from sin and I'm going to turn with all of my heart and all of my life to you, Jesus, as my Lord and as my Savior. Let it be known in heaven as well as upon the earth that I am born again. I'm a child of God, that I'm saved, and I'm headed for heaven and denying my presence in hell. Thank you, Jesus. I'm alive forevermore. Love you so much. God bless you guys. Everybody just say amen and receive Christ as your Lord and Savior. So talk to you later. God bless you.
Thank you for listening to the Rock Church and World Outreach Center. If this message spoke to you, please share it with us. We'd love to hear from you. You can find more information at www.rockchurch.com.